What's poppin', guys? It's Nyla Simone.
It's your boy DJ Spin King.
And we are live on Blizz and Trends with a very special guest.
Dream Doll in the spot.
Home team.
What's poppin'?
Hey, y'all.
What's up, Dream? How are you today?
I'm good. I'm feeling good.
Feeling good? New record out?
Yes.
Who do you love?
Featuring G-Eazy and Rocky.
I love the video.
Thank you.
And I love the record, actually.
Thank you.
I was really shocked that you got G-Eazy in the hood.
Yeah, and crazy. It's the crazy part. We was dead filming from like 9 a.m. to like 9 p.m.
With no problems. He was freezing. Just chilling out there.
Chilling outside. He ain't budge a bit.
That's funny.
But you know, he from like the hood in the Bay, so.
Oh, okay.
You know, he used to that.
How did the record come about?
All right, so bad. We was, me and my team, we flew out to L.A. because we was looking to work with different producers. So we was working with Hitmaker, and he had like a couple tracks with like features already on it. So I was like, yo, I want that. And then I just put my verse on it and I took it. that's really how it went. Like, that's the great
part. So the record was done already?
The record was done already with Rocky on it, with G-Eazy on it, and it just took clearance. He called G-Eazy on FaceTime, said, oh, I'm about to put Dream on it. He was like, I bet you got it. Like, and I took it.
The way I bodied this first verse, I'm going to just take the whole thing.
So yeah, that's how that happened.
No, that's dope.
So how long did you have the record sitting?
Clearance took like 4 months. Like right after Thought Box, I was going to release that song.
I think it was
song.
The perfect time for it too.
Yeah.
Because they was expecting something after Thought Box.
Yeah. But the clearance took so long. You know how what we had to go through?
I know.
A sample?
Nah, I could feel the stress radiating.
That's why I was like, when they said Valentine's Day, I'm like, I ain't even promoted that week that it was about to drop. I'm like, it's not going to drop. We supposed to drop it in November, December, January. So when they said February, I'm like, all right, if it's dropping, it's dropping. Then when they send me the clips, I'll post like, this tomorrow. I was like, I bet I'm dropping a song at 12.
It's real.
And that's why I dropped it the day
before. So you promoted
it
the day before?
The day before I promoted it. Because I wasn't sure if it was going to come out. And I'm tired of telling my fans that I'm going to drop something and nothing dropped.
Yeah.
So I'm like, you know what? I'm not going to get them riled up. They're not about to drag me up.
Yeah.
So if it dropped, it dropped. And then that's how, like literally the day before is when I was like, okay, bet. It's about to drop.
You got to let the fans know that it's not you.
It's not me. Like,
but they don't be trying to hear that though.
It's not at all. Especially, you know, I took the whole 2019 to like really work on my flow, my artistry. And
yeah, no, I was gonna talk about that.
Yeah.
You came back a whole new bitch.
Because like, talk
whole
to me nice, and then you just took some time to yourself.
Yeah, that's what I was really doing. Like, I literally have records that I'd be like, that
ain't
it. I'm not
gonna lie though. Like, I had really enjoyed the Talk to Me Nice, and I really like Pull Up.
Yeah,
Pull Up. Like, that was a vibe. That was,
what made you take that? What made you feel that way?
I just felt like I need to perfect myself, and I needed to find my voice. That's how
I think it's dope you ain't rush it, though.
No, I didn't rush it at all. You feel me? Even, like, when I did, you know, that freestyle.
I got to give Dream respect. I literally caught when it dropped. I caught stuff. I'm like, nah, I got so much respect for Dream Doll. I'm so happy she did this.
Like, nah, that day was like, oh, my God. I'm finally getting the credit that I deserve.
Yeah.
And it's like a lot of people in Spin, you know, coming from the nightlife, it's hard for people to take us serious in the music industry. This is not easy.
Right.
It's not easy financially. It's not easy respect-wise. So that was like the only day in my career at that moment where I felt like Dream Doll, the rapper, you feel me? And, you know, I like, that was the best feeling
was
in the world.
Was that what made you, like, turn and, like, you know what, let me go? Like,
that's when I decided to take that route with that voice.
Yeah.
That's exactly what happened.
Because I ain't going to, she knows I called it. That Thought Box verse, that verse was hard.
Yeah, thank you. And it's crazy because with that verse, I was the first person on the record. I had Nymeera's hook. And then I did my verse. And then when I heard the whole song, I'm like, yo, everybody killed it.
Yeah.
Everybody killed it.
So how'd that come about?
I guess it happened when Berg spoke to Young and May and said he wanted to do a female version. And when she was with it, that's when he hit everybody else up.
Because I ain't gonna lie, like, I like both versions, but people talk more about the girl version.
The girl version was
because
way
harder. Because it's no all women's records nowadays.
Girl version was way harder.
And I think the video brought it to life because you saw everybody unity
black
together.
Black and white, you know, everybody was there.
Yeah.
Everybody was in the same place when we was filming it. And it's just to see, like,
the love.
Different angles of the topic, you know, because not one person repeated this saying or that or that saying. It was like
everybody did body it though.
Yeah, everybody body. It was a different version of everybody.
I'm not gonna lie. First time I watched the video, I was like, nah, I didn't see Dream.
Yo, people said that when they heard the song, they're like, okay, when Dream part coming on?
Yeah, I was like, wait, no, this is Dream. Yo, Dream sound mad different.
Yo, I was watching the YouTube videos, like the reactions, and I'm like, that it was like putting a battery in my back. I'm like, let's go, I'm ready to drop.
Yeah.
And it was just like, yo, I'm like,
but then you came with it left. Because nobody expected this record from you. Because more commercial.
Especially a radio record. Yeah. Like, I'm like, okay, let me get something for that. You
especially
know?
Clearing that sample. I'm that alone. People
I'm not
going to
drop no name, but I know a couple artists that they didn't clear for, and it's like mainstream. So for that, when they cleared it for me, that's why I kept thinking, like, okay, this not about to come out.
Right.
You know? And when it actually came out, I was like, yo, that's crazy. Like, but the original version was Bernard Wright. That was the original. And then it was LL sampled it, and then it was me.
So you had to clear both sides?
No, I went straight to
the first one.
Bernard King.
But it's so are you dropping Talk to Me Nice completely?
No, that's actually like my knock out the wall. That's my baby. That's like my baby.
Okay.
So
yeah.
It's like any show I ever have, I'm always gonna perform that song, whether it's the hook.
Even the tag. Just the tag.
Yeah.
Like, even the hook.
That's my baby girl. Like, I'm always rock with that. Yeah, I'm always rock with that.
Okay, cool.
But
I was making sure it didn't get changed.
Dropping that flow, though, definitely.
Okay.
But, you know, as far as, like, Talk to Me Nice, period, I just, that's mine and I'm sticking to it. That's
fine. How hard was the transition from the bartender to the artist side?
It actually, it has its ups and downs.
Like you said, the respect thing.
Yeah, the respect thing. And also, I had to completely stop bartending because, being an artist, you have to be fully focused. I cannot, some nights not go to the studio because I got to work at night and because I can only record at night. That's the only time I can record. So it's like I had to completely cut it off and really focus and put my everything into it, like putting my money from bartending, because that was my whole thing. I didn't want to be a bartender for 4, 5, 3 years. Yeah. I didn't want to be a bartender for that long. I was saving my bag to put towards my career.
You always knew you wanted to do this?
Always. I used to rap in college, though. That's the crazy part.
No way.
Seriously. And then I met up with Self, and I told him, like, yo, I used to rap. He like, no, you didn't. I'm like, yes, I did. I'm like, I'm going to come back with a song. I went to Philly after hosting, and I went to the studio. I recorded it, came back with it, played it for Self on the speakers. He played in the Aces the next day.
Oh, that's
how it happened. And then that's my biggest song. It's my first record. It's like, how can I get away from that?
Yeah.
You know, but it's definitely been challenging, but now it's better, you know.
You feel taking off that year really helped you?
Yeah. I have a lot. I'm on a lot of people's albums. I have a lot more people hitting me up for features, mainstream. I have a lot more people taking me serious. And even producer-wise, because I had... Y'all wouldn't even believe the type of situation that I would be dealing with when it comes to people in the industry.
So you feel like they wouldn't take you seriously?
Yeah. Like, I ain't no video vixen. Like, I'm an artist. You gonna respect that.
Yeah.
And that's just that. But bartending helped me get my way through, you know? But it's all about knowing when to get
transition and get out.
Yeah.
I respect it.
That's real.
But I got a lot of my peoples from bartending, so they support me, especially with DJs. Like, I would have never met Spin King.
I'm about to say, that's love. You already in the network.
Yeah,
so
I would have never met Self. I would have never met half of the DJs that I know. And one thing is, I have a genuine relationship with Spin King, with Self, with every DJ in here that I had before I even started, like, got in the music industry.
Yeah.
So it's like, it was like a...
Organic, in a sense.
Organic, you know?
And it's dope to see somebody actually make it from that, because you give them hope. You know what I'm saying?
I see girls now. I'll be like, hey, girl, do what you got to do. Facts.
You got to respect it.
So what's new? What's coming in 2020?
So we're working on a project. Well, we actually have a project done.
Okay.
So, you know, now that I'm signed to the label, it's like the...
How do you feel with that situation?
It feels better. Like, that's why it feels better. You know, it's financially
you're not by yourself,
better.
Right? You're
not I'm
by
not
yourself.
By myself. I have a full team. Whether it's my publicist, whether it's my day-to-day, whether it's my managers. Like, right. I have 3 managers, like, and all of them do different stuff, you know? So it's like, it's the best thing. It's more weight off my shoulders where I could just focus on being an artist.
Right.
You know? But that's the best, that's one of the best parts about it. And it's like, things are not as hard. Because when I was independent, I see myself, like, really... I felt like I was begging people to do me favors. Like, and I'll do something for them and I'll be like, yo, like, you don't remember? You know, so it'll be like, but then now it's like my label, they'll come and they'll take care of this. I'll be already on lined up for that show for that, you know. And it, I feel like it's more of a struggle when you not when you're independent to like really be on like the
festivals
and, exactly.
And your mind gets so clogged, you stop focusing on music because it becomes so much other politics
business
stuff.
And your politics.
Yeah. But it's like the relationships that I developed that I got from being signed to a label I didn't have before. And even like it just it helped me to be patient because I'm not a patient. I was not a patient person. But when ever since I like it's like everything is like in the palm of the label. I had to learn like
you used to be like you cannot record it.
Record, drop the next day. Yeah. EP, drop the next month. Yeah. But then it keeps the people waiting and more intrigued and when I dropped, like when I said I'm dropping something, I aired it on 42nd Street.
Yeah, so
and you know 42nd Street to us is like I used to go there when I was younger, take the train down there.
In admiration.
BBQs. Yeah. So for me to see myself up there, it's like, yo, like
It's real, it's happening.
Yeah. You know? And just to see like this that's another thing when it comes to my label. It's like he made this happen. It's like, oh my God, this ain't happened before.
Yeah.
You know, but just to have that my video play and even to be up there and it's like, yo, I used to come here when I was young. I used to be in Forever 21, all the stores over here, and it's like, dang, I'm up there now. So it was a real emotional moment for me because I'm from New York, so it meant more to me than the artist from LA that, you know, I'm from here, this is my home.
Yeah.
So I'm on 42nd Street Billboard, like, but that's not gonna be the last, you know.
That's fire.
I like the energy.
Yeah, dope. It's not gonna be the last. So
the tape dropping, you have a name for the tape already?
We ain't released the name yet.
Okay,
we didn't release the name. We didn't release the cover yet.
Okay,
but when can
you
we
know
expect
all
it?
Of that be like scheduled? When that's what I'm saying. That patience.
She's like, this is different.
I would have been like, girl, it's gonna be.
You think about the summer?
Yeah, definitely before the summer.
Okay.
But who you got on the tape? Can you say that?
You know, that's another thing. Clearances. So what happens if I release a name and then they first don't clear?
Boop. Got it. Okay.
I respect it. I understand.
All right.
Yeah, they verse on clear. I'm over there going to be like, oh, what happened to that feature? And I'm like,
if that's the case, put it on SoundCloud so we can still have it.
You know what? I was thinking about that with my old stuff. I'm like, why I didn't put even like the music that I was working on all 2019?
Yeah.
I'm like, I should have just released those on SoundCloud.
It's the evolution. It's the evolution of dream.
Facts. I should have just released them on SoundCloud.
But we here now.
Good,
but we here now.
Single out now. Dream Doll G Easy.
The Dream Care Package.
Yeah. Dream Care Package.
Yeah.
Who do you love out now? The video's fire.
Thank you. We did it. I wanted to do it in Eden Wall, but we actually did it in the Low East Side.
Okay.
Yeah. It was lit though. Like everybody in the project was coming downstairs, participated in the video.
Cause they're probably so surprised to see him
there. Yeah. Like even when I was rolling the dice, we just met those guys. I swear to God, they was already rolling dice outside. I'm like, yo, let me get the dice.
Perfect.
And organic.
It just happened.
Yeah.
You know, but. And Spang, I'm proud of you too.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
You know, all about growth. You too. You know, we, 2020, 2019, that's the year of growth.
Going crazy.
You know, and Spang showing y'all too, it's a way out.
Yeah. And the year of dream, 2020. Right, new music on the way.
Facts.
Project on the way.
Okay.
Shout out to your IG.
Okay.
Where they can show your music.
My Instagram is @DreamDoll. My music is streaming on every social media platform, every streaming platform. Make sure you go get my single, Who You Lovin', featuring G-Eazy and Rocky, produced by Hitmaker. Yeah.
I didn't know Hitmaker produced that. That's dope.
Yeah, I got 4 tracks.
For real?
Facts and
that's
stash.
That's fire.
And the stash. I can't wait to drop. I swear to God.
You don't miss. I'm looking for it. I'm looking for it.
And you know he ain't going to put, he gonna make sure that.
Yeah.
It's definitely gonna be a hit.
Yeah.
So we got 4 of them in the cut, with 2 singles and 1 with a featured artist, another guy. So I'm ready, really prepared for that.
Guy, singer or a rapper?
A singer.
Okay. I can't get the features, but I can guess.
Yeah, I gave that.
All right, Dream. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you, guys.
Appreciate you.